I wear my wings.
My name is Erricka Bridgeford. I graduated in the class of 1990. To me, what it means to be a Western Dove is that you are always supported. You always, even if you forget, even if you struggle, you always have a good foundation to remember your greatness and who you really are. The way Western prepared me for what I'm doing now is it was important to be in an all-girl environment. The world teaches girls that we should be quiet, that we should just sit still and look pretty, that we should wait for men to tell us how to move, or we should be trying to impress men. And Western taught me that my womanhood was important in the world, whatever that looked like. That I needed to stand firm in what it meant for me to be a woman and to be a strong woman. And so now that I'm doing work where I am asking an entire city, Baltimore has one of the biggest egos you will ever meet. And I'm asking the city to let's open our hearts together and let's heal a monumental problem like the murder epidemic. That is a huge thing. And many people have told me, men especially, have said that it is important that a woman birthed this movement, the Baltimore Ceasefire 365. That had a man birthed it and had a man been like a big face and voice in it, that it would move a lot differently. That it would not be as inclusive. So I'm glad I had an all-girl environment to be my full self in, to fall in, to crash and burn in, and to rise in. One of my favorite memories at Western, in my 10th grade year, I wanted to be vice president of the class. And all in 9th grade, I thought nobody really liked me. There was a very prissy school back then, very girly girl kind of school. And I had masculine energy in the way that I moved. And I just wasn't as ladylike, you know, as a lot of the girls were at that time. And so by my 10th grade year, I wanted to be vice president of the class, but I didn't think that it was actually going to happen, but I figured I might as well try. And I was giving my speech and when we were doing elections or whatever, and I was giving my speech, and so many people, like just when they called my name to come out on stage, people stood up and clapped, and I was like, what? These people see me? They don't even hardly pay me any mind. And little did I know that so many girls in the school, they didn't know how to engage with me because I had one hand and because I was loud and I was from a different part of town than a lot of them were from. But they admired that I was being all of that at school around them. And so this gave them an opportunity, it gave them permission to let me know that they saw me. And that was the first time that I really understood it's just important to be yourself. Whether it seems like people care or not, it doesn't matter if they'll ever care. If you are just being yourself, you will defy whatever other people try to plan for you.